Welcome to worship at First United Methodist Church, Maumelle. My name is Kyle Berry, and I'll be singing some worship music with you this morning. I'm glad you're here in this room or watching us online. No matter when it is, we're glad you chose to tune in. Today we have a special service. Today is Commitment Sunday, and we have these commitment cards that we'll be turning in to help plan for the 2024 budget. This does not go in the offering plate. There is a place later in the service after the sermon where our guest preacher will be instructing all of this. So do not put this in the offering plate. There is a special time that this will happen. You might get another announcement. You might not. So please remember. So if you would, with that, all that out of the way, please rise and join us as we sing our praises this morning. We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory, yeah. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. And we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. Cross and He rose up from the grave. My God, still rolling stones away. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. And we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. would like to invite you back to your seats, and you may be seated. Our service is a little bit out of order today, and I now invite our pastor, Reverend Justin Ledbetter, to the front to talk about our offering. And not commitment cards.
Me. Good morning. I'm Reverend Justin Ledbetter. It's my joy to serve as pastor of this church, of First Maumelle. Welcome to those of you that are worshiping with us online. Welcome to all of us that are gathered here in our Life Center this morning. A little bit different today. It's a special Sunday. It's Commitment Sunday as we commit of our time, talent, and treasure to the life of the church for the year ahead. If you are worshiping with us virtually this morning as we share in our offering and tithes, we invite you to give electronically if you would like. We invite you as well to lift up prayers that you may have, just to share them in the comments. If you have a confidential prayer to share, just direct message us, and we'll see to follow up with you in prayer this week. If you need to speak to me or one of the staff or the leaders, again, just message us, and we'll do our best to follow up with you. If there are places in the life of the church that you're interested in knowing more about, again, just share there in the Q&A section. For those of us that are gathered here in person, we invite you, as always, to make a mark of your presence on our Connect card, to fill out a prayer on the back side. You may have a joy to share, a concern to share, or you may as well have a confidential care, just to mark confidential on the card. And following the service, our ushers will see that the tithes and offerings are given to our treasurer, to Shannon, and that any cards of prayer concerns or other cards for the life of the church, that I will receive those cards. Some of you may still have the little yellow card. You may have been looking at it and thinking about your prayer life, about places where you can be present and serve in the life of the church, be it the chair ministry or any number of things. We invite you just to drop that card in the offering plate. But as Kyle said, today is a special day, and one of those commitments is our commitment to Christ and His church through the giving of our finances. And so we do, later in the service, want to invite you, please, to fill out the commitment card, to make your best guess at your best effort, and to fold the card. Together we'll be invited forward in this service and in the traditional service as well, to share in our hope chest, as we learn about in the Bible, and the Joash chest. We'll all place our commitment cards in the chest, and they'll be closed. Our treasurer, Ms. Shannon Tate, will receive them to compile our pledges for the year to come and to keep up with us throughout the year, to share giving statements and all those fun sorts of things. But as the ushers are prepared to share, I want to invite us, please, simply to pray. God, we give you thanks for the life that you have given us, for the faith that we have, and for the effort that we make, God, to love you and all of our neighbors. And so, Lord, bless our church, those gathered here and there and everywhere. Bless the gifts that we make. Bless the prayers that we share. But Lord, lead us as we lean into you and our love for you and for your church and our community, as we seek to reach others with the good news of Jesus through our prayers, presence, gifts, service, and witness. Bless us simply, Lord, as we offer not just these gifts, but even ourselves to you. For we pray the way which you have taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
darkest of weather, though I can't see, I still believe you're good. And I'm moving forward through crashing waves. I know I'm safe.
This time, I would like to welcome Steve up for our children's sermon.
Good morning. I'd like to invite the children down for the children's message. Hi, guys. How are y'all? All right, so do y'all ever make promises? You make a promise? Do you ever make a pledge? To the flag, right? We pledge allegiance to our flag and in schools and at different things, right? So what's making a promise? A pledge is like a promise. When we say pledge allegiance to the flag, what are we saying that we'll do? What do you think, Matt? To respect the flag and to be kind of a citizen of our country and a good citizen, right? What about, you guys are scouts, what about the scout oath? What are we pledging to do when we say the scout oath? Yeah, to be kind and be safe and be good scouts, right? So there's lots of vows and people say vows when they get married and they make a commitment to each other, and there's lots of things that are, like Ella said, are kind of promise, right? So today is Commitment Sunday, and we're going to talk about and kind of make a promise and a commitment to our church. And part of that commitment is being a member of our church, supporting the things that our church does, giving our time and our money and the talents that we have, the things that we're good at, okay? All of these pledges and promises are words that we say, right? Can we do the things that we're promising to do it without saying the words? Can you be a good citizen of America without saying the Pledge of Allegiance every day? Can you be a good scout without saying the scout oath every time you do something? Can we be good Christians and members of our church without making a commitment on Commitment Sunday? So why do we make these pledges and oaths and covenants and promises and all these things? Why do we have these little ceremonies where we do this kind of thing out loud? So everybody knows that you're going to do it? Well, if everybody knows that you're going to do it, what happens if you don't do it? You know that they know, right? And so these little ceremonies and commitments and promises and pledges and oaths and things that we say, by saying them out loud, we've told everybody that we're going to do them. And so that kind of builds in us an extra commitment to do it, right? It helps to remind us to do it, all right? So, yeah, we can do all these things without saying the oath or the pledge or the, but if we do make those oaths, we make those promises, we need to keep them, right? All right, will y'all say a prayer with me? Dear God, thank you for this day, and thank you for your promises to us. Help us to remember our promises to you and share your love with those around us. Amen.
Good morning. I wanted to let you know how good it is to be here again. I've been here a couple of times in the last year or so, and I'm thrilled to be here on this Commitment Sunday as a part of this congregation. I want to thank Pastor Justin, my friend, your pastor, for this invitation, and count it as a great blessing to be here. As a member of our cabinet, and that means that I'm one of those who's responsible for making appointments and assigning pastors, I want to say that I count it as a great blessing to know that I had something to do with this pastor-parish relationship. And I am so glad to be a part of that and trust that good, good things are going to come from this congregation. And I'm going to say a lot more about that in just a moment. Our scripture for this Commitment Sunday comes from Paul's letter to the Romans, the 12th chapter. And so I invite you to hear these words. And I can already tell that my version is a little bit different from the version on the screen that I'm going to be reading from. So you get to hear it in two different ways. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, on the basis of God's mercy, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this age, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good, acceptable, and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function, we who are one body in Christ, and individually, we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith. Ministry in our ministering. The teacher in teaching. The encourager in encouragement. The giver in sincerity. The leader in diligence. The compassionate in cheerfulness. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in affliction. persevere in prayer, contribute to the needs of the saints, and one more, pursue hospitality, practice hospitality to strangers. My friends, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us have a moment of prayer together. Oh God, as we sing your word and sing your praises, as we hear your word read and proclaimed, may each of us this day hear with joy what you say to us in our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In reflecting back, I think of one particular Sunday school teacher that was so that was such a blessing to me. And I remember one particular conversation. This Sunday school teacher kind of called me apart, and we were having this serious conversation about faith. And he said to me, "Michael, I want you to know that to someone out there, you are an example of what it means to be a Christian." I remember this like it was yesterday because it hit me so hard. Someone might be looking to me and think, "Oh, so that's what it's like to be a follower of Christ." That is a big responsibility, to know that we have that kind of influence on others when, as Steve said with the children, when we claim it out loud, when we make that kind of commitment and that pledge. It is a big responsibility. Along those same lines, a good friend of mine tells this story on himself when he was a student at Hendricks College. A professor called him into the office, and the professor said to the student, I'm not going to say his name, "Are you still planning to go to seminary and to be a pastor in the United Methodist Church?" And the student said, "Yes, yeah, of course that's what I'm planning on doing." And the professor said, "Do you know that you and I are the only ones on this campus who know that or who would believe it?" It was a wake-up call. People might be looking to us and saying, "Oh, so that's what it means to be a follower of Christ." It's really kind of scary to think that others might be might be learning from us and evaluating faith by our actions and attitudes, maybe even seeing us as a model to emulate. I want to turn now to our passage from Romans. And because this is kind of a one sermon, I'm here one time, I want to give a big kind of overview of the whole letter to the Romans in just a couple of sentences. In this big letter, Paul spends the first 11 chapters telling us what God has done for us. The grace, the forgiveness, the mercy that God has given to us through Jesus Christ our Lord. That's the first 11 chapters in a nutshell. And then Paul begins chapter 12 with the word "therefore." And then he goes on to spend the rest of the letter talking about how we are to live in the light of this good news that comes to us in the first 11 chapters. Here's what God has done for you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, here's God's calling upon your life. That's the rest of the letter. So in this very first verse of chapter 12, Paul says, "Therefore, I appeal to you by the mercies of God, present your bodies as a living sacrifice." Now, to my ears, this term "living sacrifice," it sounds kind of strange to my ears. A sacrifice means to give of your life so that others might live. And Paul is calling us to be a living sacrifice, to give of our lives, of our resources, of our talents, so that others might come to know the mercy and the grace and the forgiveness of God. This is the first therefore. Then Paul goes on to say in verse 2, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And this verse sounds a little bit strange to my ears as well. And I think it's because this notion of not conforming runs so counter to my instinct, and I would say to your instincts as well, because we like to conform. We like to fit in. And here Paul is saying, do not conform. And if that was the last word here, then it would be hard to swallow, but it's not the last word. Paul goes on to say, but be transformed. Transformed into the grace of God. My friends, we can be transformed. Hate can be transformed into love. Suffering can be transformed into joy. Death, in all the forms in which it comes, can be transformed into new life, new beginnings, new opportunities, new possibilities, even into eternity. It is so much more fulfilling for us to focus our lives around the transforming power of God than it is for us to try to conform to the ways of the world, because doing that is just not going to bring the life and the love that the world often promises. This is the second therefore in chapter 12. Do not conform. Focus on being transformed by the grace of God. I want to jump down to verse 9 because I'm not going to go through every one of these verses. What I will tell you is that I would love for you to go home this week, and I would love for you to read these therefores in the 12th chapter of Romans. Maybe even commit some of them to memory. Write them upon your heart. I want to look at verse 9 for a moment and look at some of these exhortations that are given. This word exhortation, it's kind of a fancy church word. Exhortation. An exhortation is a short sentence that is a call to action. Exhortations almost always begin with a verb. They are calls to action, short statements that call us into some kind of action. And in starting with verse 9, we have a list of traditional exhortations in this way. And the first one in chapter 9 is this: let love be genuine. That's where it starts. And we know, my friends, what this love is. This love is patient. This love is kind. This love is not arrogant or rude. This love does not insist on its own way. Let love be genuine. And then the next one is, hate what is evil. So here, evil is the opposite of love. And if that's the case, then what would evil look like? Well, perhaps then evil would look like being impatient. Evil would look like arrogance. Evil might look like insisting on our own way. Hate what is evil. The next one, hold fast to what is good. In our culture, we use this word good in a very casual way. So we'll say something like, that was a good meal, or that was a good show. Well, it may have been tasty, it may have been entertaining, but may not have been good in the way that this word is used in the scriptures. Good is what is life-giving. Good is what brings love into the world. Note the similarities between the words or the name God and good. That's not an accident in the English language. What is of God is good. What is truly good is from God. Here's the next exhortation. Hold fast to what is good. I want to jump down to the one that in the version that I read says, outdo one another in showing honor. What I love about this is that it is a call to compete. Outdo one another. We're called to compete in showing honor to one another. So here's my question around this exhortation for you. Are you winning? Or are you even in the game? Outdo one another in showing honor. I want to highlight one more here, and that is the one that says, contribute to the needs of the saints. On this Commitment Sunday, we're talking about making a contribution. A contribution to what? I love the way Paul kind of phrases it here, making a contribution to the needs of the saints. So this begs some questions. Who are the saints? Paul uses this word frequently in his letters, and every time makes it pretty clear that we are the saints. The saints are the body of Christ. In kind of sharing what it means to be a saint, I love the old story, the story of a grandparent taking grandchildren into an old cathedral. And they're looking up at the stained glass windows with all of these people in the stained glass windows. And the grandparent takes this as a teaching moment and says, who are the saints? To the grandchildren. And one child says, I know. The saints are the ones who let the light shine through. I love that definition. We are called to be those who let the light shine through. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Contribute to the needs of those who let God's light shine through, as the church, as the body of Christ is called to do. And what then are the needs of the saints? Contribute to the needs of the saints. Sometimes when we hear this word need, we think in terms of self and selfishness and what do I need? But that's not what's going on here. The needs of the saints are listed in these verses. It's the work of the body of Christ in the world. In this congregation, you can see it on that little yellow slip. These are some of the needs of the saints. And we're going to talk more about that in just a moment. As we lead into that time to talk a little bit about our commitment, here are some questions. How are you being called to contribute to this holy work? What is your therefore? Here's what God has done for us. Here's what God has done for me through the grace and the mercy and the forgiveness and life-giving presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, what is God calling me to do? My friends, I will make this commitment to you, this promise to you, this pledge to you. As you strive to live out a faithful life through your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness, you will be blessed. You will come to know more and more all of the blessings that come to us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Receive that promise. Amen. And now I'm going to come down on the floor to be with y'all, and we're going to talk some about this a little bit more. As we lean into a time when we make our when we do make our commitment to God. You have a couple of sheets, or you should have them. If you don't, we can get them to you during the commitment time. You could go out and get them. But I do want to just highlight a couple of things. You do have this yellow sheet, or you've had access to this. It's a membership covenant. And you're asked to make some promises here, some commitments of prayers, of presence, of gifts, and of service, and of witness. There are some scripture passages here. I hope that you will take this. I want you to turn this in. I hope that you will read these passages. Let them inform your life. And I want to highlight just one, and that's the last one here. They're all very important, but the last one is what it means to witness. You are invited to commit to speak to others about how God is working in your life and your church when the opportunity arises for you to share in this way. As a congregation, you are in a congregation, First United Methodist Church of Maumelle, into a new season of growth. You are moving into a season of restoration of a great witness in this community. A witness where the love of God is shared with all. A witness of God's grace that covers our lives. A witness of mission in this community that has been recognized for years about how much this congregation does to make this a better place. You get to be a part of that, a part of this restoration of that witness, a part of that growth. And I am so, so thankful for that. On the back side of this, you'll see just some opportunities of places where you might serve. I invite you again to just think of that word, therefore. Think of all that God has done for you. Therefore, what can you give back? What can you do to be a part of this restoration, to be a part of this growth, this witness into the world? And then you have a commitment card, a financial commitment card here. And Pastor Justin said this earlier, but I do want to highlight that this is a commitment. Some commitments are also contracts. This one is not a contract. This is the desire of your heart. Circumstances might change, and you may even be able to give more, but this is an expression of the desire of your heart. So I want us to take a moment to pray, and then give you some time to either fill out or to bring or to take what you have brought with you, to come forward during the singing of our song. There's the chest here that you can put your commitment cards in, and trust that you will be blessed in the midst of that. So my friends, let us pray together. Come, Holy Spirit. Breathe your living word as we gather for worship. Breathe your guidance and grace into our lives. Breathe your courage into us as we seek to be instruments of your peace. Breathe your healing grace upon all who are in need. As we come together to enter into this new season, this new season of blessings and growth, may your anointing be upon us. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen. I do invite you to come forward and to dedicate your commitments at the altar.
My will.
song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you.
We'll have our charge conference meeting in the sanctuary, so come on there. And also this Friday, the 17th, at 12:30, we will have our initial women's group meeting. If you are interested in joining the United Women in Faith, which is like the official women's group of the United Methodist Church, join us this Friday for lunch. Lunch will be provided at 12:30. Come join us.
Please rise and join us as we sing our closing song this morning.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. Even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. I will fear no evil, for my God is with me, and if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, never.
Thank you. Y'all are so blessed to have this group of people to help lead you in worship. They really are good. I go into a lot of congregations around the state. They are such a blessing. It's been great to be with you today. I leave you with this benediction. May the grace, the love, the forgiveness, and the mercy of Christ, all those things that we hear about in the first 11 chapters of Romans, be in your heart. And may you go forth with a therefore as well. May God give you opportunities to pray, to give, to serve, to be a witness. May gifts of love, mercy, grace, and forgiveness into the world. And as you do so, know that you will be blessed. Know that God will be with you. Amen.